Bam. Hello, and welcome back to this hideous death trap.
How's it?
That was worth waiting for. We have Dude. Now blown the way clear, for in the adventures of Gordon Freeman, soldier scientist, We've made it to the surface and are now having to tackle those bloody soldiers again.
Baron science fight. You puffed and you blew some shit up.
Just can't take the hint, these lads.
Surely there'd be a point where, you know, even a well-trained military force getting bodied by one dude would be like, this is a bit...
Damn it, there's no cover here at all.
Okay.
Tactics. What are you doing?
We missed a billion of these grenades.
This is the only point in the game where you see these barrels rise up in the air as they explode. They just put this in at this point for giggles.
It's kind of a bummer because I think if the explosion came up with them and they hit sort of higher levels, you know, you could see that sort of being scattered.
You can see where the
indoor areas.
See where the fascination with physics came from. The valve software.
I suppose that would have.
Oh bum again.
Higher.
I'm just gonna stop wasting those. Aha! A chopper. And the Gauss gun is the hidden trump card against these things.
Gauss or Gauss?
I say Gauss.
Okay. I like how when you got it out, he spun it. Like, I don't think that was necessary. Something's fucking...
Oh, bugger. Someone's got some kind of mortar over there and all.
Pew!
Yep. Pow!
Alrighty.
Jesus. Oh, why isn't it dead yet? Well, it's smoking, that's something.
Well, that's, you know, smoking is a sure way to kill yourself, so...
Shit, it fired prematurely, because it ran out of ammo.
Let's try to get that.
Okay, time to be Quick Draw McGraw against the helicopter. Try it in real life, kids.
Phew. I'm sure you can... Just shine one of those green laser pointers at it. Oh.
Wow, I don't remember helicopters firing missiles like that. Maybe they added some code from the Half-Life 2 helicopter.
Is there any way to tell if you're...
Ah, who the fuck knows? I will try to tranquilize the helicopter. Oh, that didn't
we'll
work.
We'll tranquilize it, we'll net it, and then we'll release it somewhere where it's, you know, it's safe and it can't hurt anybody else.
I'm determined to kill this thing somehow.
Maybe shoot the dude to the left who's firing crap at you. Like, there's an awful lot going on over there, which I think should be dealt with.
Yeah, I will, you assholes.
You guys are jerks.
There.
You've got one.
Every one health you have is a slap in the face of the enemy. Bugger, I fell in the sea.
Are there things in here?
Oh, bugger. Oh. Yes, there's one of those things. Okay, this isn't totally lost yet.
That was tactics.
Something exploded.
That jerk. Because I remember this section now from, like, the one in this... Do you have to push the button in there?
Yeah. I'm just, seeing if that helicopter's gonna continue trying to make friends.
I don't think he's quite done with you yet.
Oh, bugger.
I don't think he's good enough to shoot a missile in the door, though, so...
Incidentally, these health kits dispense 40 health in medium difficulty.
What are they doing hard?
I think it's 50 on easy and 25 on hard. Away! Yeah. Now to turn this wheel. Hopefully not drown.
Isn't there, like, Mr. Fishy in here with you?
Oh, there he is.
He's having the funs.
Eager to make his presence felt, as always, aren't we, Mr. Fishy? Oh, some armor, that'll help. I like losing a whole bunch of health and then having to continue. It was like extra challenge. Extra challenge for the stupid player.
There's no recovery of health here.
That's my kind of biz. So the military are continuing to be assholes. And we're continuing to be a thorn in their side.
Thorny Gordon. Kids used to call him at private school.
I think that was just a reference to his beard there.
Oh, is that... Hey. You got more gauss.
More of something.
Or your geese rifle.
I've got an itchy contact grenade trigger finger.
They are a lot of fun. Like, the contact grenades are always,
Yeah, it's a... I mean, the assault rifle tends to be the standard fallback weapon for most situations, and if the situation, like, gets too heated, it can be a quick solution.
Yeah.
What?
Alright.
Yeah, they really load you down with recovery items in this game.
You seem to take a lot of damage. Like...
Well, I didn't have much suit armor up till now.
That's a good point. I'm gonna get rid of that jerk.
I'm actually not sure we can. I mean, you could in the original by, like, Gauss gunning his ass off, but I poured a whole bunch of ammunition into him and it didn't seem to help.
He did start smoking, though, so that's, like, to me that kind of change indicates that you're having some kind of effect.
Oh, yes, well, there is that.
Although, I don't know, I can...
Don't start smoking, kids, because your helicopter might explode.
Yeah, it's a good way to lose your helicopter.
Hey.
That one's not smoking, so I don't know what's going on. I have to fucking ignore it.
I think it's a different helicopter altogether.
Two helicopters.
You didn't learn, did you? You wouldn't let it lie. Here's a man who's killed my entire squad because they missed it because they suddenly appeared in front of him without cover and he had a shotgun. I think it's time to show him I mean business. Is what he said.
They're an impressively disciplined army to be able to keep coming at what has so far proven to be an unstoppable one-man killing machine.
Hmm.
Like, because that's... We're well beyond the point where I'd be attacking Gordon. Be like, darkness is approaching. I'm running away.
Well, if you've ever read about warfare during the First World War, you know that the military has never been great at pattern recognition.
Have you been watching the Great War YouTube series?
No, what's that?
Well, it's a YouTube series. There's one episode a week for the entire duration of the 100th anniversary of World War One. And
okay, so it's going to be running for 4 years.
Yeah,
is it?
Yeah, it's been running for about I think almost a year now. A bit over one. No, yeah, it's a bit over a year.
Never forget.
Well, it's really interesting, and especially when they go over like,
hey.
All right, so
turns out there was a mine there.
When they go over the. Just the amount of fucking stupid shit. Like, none of it was necessary. It's such a bizarre war.
Like the British troops being told to walk slowly across the enemy's field of view for no particular reason. Except because we have to be British and phlegmatic about things.
Or the French uniforms being like these crazy pomp and ceremony uniforms to show off, like, look, we're France on the battlefield, and making them the most easy to see and hit things on, like, ever.
Yeah.
And it took them ages to get rid of that. They knew it was happening. It was like, well, you know.
Yeah, well, the British army uniforms were like bright red blazers all the way through the colonial years. But they did change that up for the Great War, of course.
Yeah. Well, by the Great War, they actually had a professional army.
Oh.
Huh?
Here's time for a classic Half-Life moment. Hey.
Did the Valve theme just... play?
Yeah.
Oh.
To illustrate this extraordinary skybox. Apparently you can tranquilize gun turrets now.
That's what happens when you make them artificially intelligent.
That's what happens! Did you see?
Do you see?
Yes, I see. Blah.
I can't even... Oh yeah, that's right.
Where are they all? Bow, 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 bow. I think they're down below somewhere. This is the Donald Duck portion of the song.
Slightly porn groove. Ow. Yeah, get my dick out. I'm a scientist.
They don't even need me to kill them anymore, do they? What an inept bunch.
Bungling, I think, is where we're getting into. We're officially getting into bungling territory.
Yeah, this isn't the real military. This was, you know, a short bus happened to be driving past.
This is what happens when PMCs bollocks. That doesn't look... Yeah.
It was fading out there. I hardly thought that was necessary. I was about to splat horribly. Right. Let's tranquilize this thing again.
Yep. Go to sleep, little robot.
Or dream of can openers and busty wenches with WD-40.
No more pain where you're going. WD-40?
Plenty of pain where he was.
Yeah.
Pain to spare. Pain all round, boys.
Because he might have been conscious when that rocket, kind of the grenade, kind of popped him off the cliff.
Yeah, his head was probably still aware for about 11 seconds.
Yeah. Enough time to go, well, this sucks. Okay, he probably wasn't.
Jibbed. Or gibbed. I say jibbed because it's short for giblet, obviously.
Yeah, that's how I've always... Have you two seen the new episodes of The X-Files? If so, what do you think? If not, do you ever intend to watch it? From Morally Peculiar.
No and no.
Yes.
Oh, yeah. Bum. I got excited.
Are you doing, like, the wacky way of getting down? Because I swear, though, weren't you meant to go, like... Okay.
I'd say
there's a pattern is beginning to form here.
It's these bloody slopes. And I don't mean the racial epithet.
Oh, okay.
See, what they want you to do...
It will be that when you start complaining about damn chinks.
What they want you to do is jump across these rickety planks. But fortunately, as long as it has mass, we can walk on it. So we're just going to use the rope.
That's...
And walk perfectly straight.
The circus skills that Gordon took in high school...
And here's
finally
a
finally becoming useful.
Couldn't be asked.
You found a lot of contact grenades earlier. Now I think you're being a little bit of a...
Well, there's never a shortage. That's American military spending for you. I remember hearing an anecdote that the American military wrote a letter to their government and said, we don't need any more tanks.
Yeah.
Please don't put tanks in this year's budget. And the politicians went, fuck you, we won't get votes if we do that. And they put a vote and they put more tanks in anyway.
What do they do with them all? I suppose somewhere there's just like
probably
sort of a...
Play bumper cars or something.
Yeah, there's like some kind of Sergeant Bilko situation where there's just sort of a bunch of... You know, they run some tires around the edges of them so they don't ding them up too bad.
And here's the famous rocket launcher.
That follows the laser.
Laser targeted. So you shoot it and then the rocket will go towards whatever you point the laser at.
For like example... Mr. Fucking Helicopter.
Oh, bugger.
Interesting.
I don't know what happened there. Did that hit him?
I think he deployed like chaff or some shit.
He's never
that
done.
Got him. That fucking hit him.
Deployed chaff? Has he been to helicopter school?
Probably. I mean, I figure at least one of these soldiers, like the fucking helicopter pilot, probably have to have. All right, you don't want to.
Sake. Right, you're getting the laser of God. Fucking hell, he's not even smoking. Okay, this is getting dumb. What is going on with these helicopters in this source?
That was that was bold, the decision to try and get it with a contact grenade.
It was an applied decision.
Oh, yeah, it's, you know, I'm sure on one of its strafes you'd actually have a solid shot of hitting it. See, if I were playing this would be driving me insane because I can't even tell if I'm contacting it. Like, I think that got it.
See if I can get it to smoking at the stage with this.
So I'm trying to work out where its hitbox is, like if you're... Because sometimes it looks like things miss, but maybe it's just kind of got a big wonky square hitbox.
So have you seen the new X-Files episode?
Yes.
What did you think?
It's kind of interesting because it's only 10 episodes per season, so they've sort of compressed an awful lot of it. So we've got a kind of...
How cute that you think that's a small season.
10 episodes?
Yeah, I'm used to British television.
Yeah. You get three episodes and then a Christmas special and fuck you.
Six episodes and they concentrate the good.
Yeah, well, I mean, you know, X-Files used to be a full 26 run, you know, so...
There's a whole lot of chaff in American television.
Oh, yeah.
Bugger this, I'm going to try again with all the rockets.
Yeah, this has been a bit of a...
Right. Now, do it...
It's turning into a kerfuffle.
Now, properly this time, Gordon.
You can do it, 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 you can do it. Alright, okay. That hit something.
That was definitely an explosion at its nose.
So, like, we've had the... Okay.
What the fuck was that? That went straight through him! This is driving me up the wall. Okay, that got him.
This is bullshit.
It really is.
Now, all right. Okay.
Now we're wearing a little smoking
jacket. Does that have
a
range? Like a maximum range, the fucking gorse tickle thing?
Probably.
I'm just, you know.
Die!
The sad thing is that I feel like that's probably the...
No, that's still not working, is it?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, I feel like if we don't get it done with all our heavy weapons, then we might as well not bother trying.
Yeah, like, do we have to do this, is my question.
Well, yeah, because otherwise we're going to be trying to climb up this cliff with this asshole floating about.
What I'm trying to work out is, does killing it, is it necessary to kill it to open a path, or does its continued existence just make climbing a bit of a hassle?
It is the latter.
Okay, alright.
I've always killed him at this point.
But we're playing the wonky fucking version. My concern is, has something fucked up somewhere, and are we shooting, like, you know, is this helicopter immortal, like the fucking security guard?
My concern is not giving the viewers particular closure for this fucking segment.
Well, you know.
We're not going to hang around trying to destroy the chopper for 3 hours and then not destroy the chopper.
I think maybe wait until he's closer. Because that shot definitely fucking clipped him.
Well, I'd like to help you, but...
Fuck. I think that got him. It exploded.
Well...
That got it.
No, it went through him.
No, we'll see. I think it's going around it. And they don't sort of double back.
I forgot there's a kick to this gun. Speedrunners use it to do, like, gauss jumps.
Boosty. Speedrunners are weird, man.
Yeah, they're a weird bunch.
Yeah! Alright! Right in the face. And he's smoking already! How's that?
Yeah. He fell in with a bad crowd in high school.
Yeah. Probably only 2 years old. Alright.
Alright.
Some two solid shots there. Yes, no, did... what?
Yes, no, whatever. Oh, come on.
Whee!
Yeah, spin that little thing with frustration, Gordon.
What does that do, Gordon?
Oh, for fuck's sake. Try this again.
Suicide. So yeah, like, X-Files... has given us a slightly dull major conspiracy episode. An incredibly delightful, wacky episode.
As far as I recall, it was mainly wacky episodes, X-Files.
No, you get a lot of Monster of the Week.
I swear, that went through him again.
That got it.
Yeah, that got him.
I think it's because the laser is off him at some points. That, all right, now look, that's three fucking rockets.
And a fully charged Gauss shot.
All right, look, I'm making an official vote for runaway, because this is bullshit.
Oh, fine.
I mean, you've hit that, I think, fair, and too little to no avail.
Yeah, you stay down there.
Yeah, I don't think it's even
going to
figure it out.
It's a big toilet where the shits live.
Yep.
That's where you
are
now.
The big poo. Oh. Oopsie doodles.
Oh, shit.
It's
because Half-Life is full of narrow ledge stuff, and this section is the fucking... And now we combine the narrow ledge with the dodgy ladder physics.
This is getting Wile E. Coyote-ish. Like, just, that's all I'm seeing in my head now is that great little...
I guess that's appropriate.
...poff as you hit the ground. Whoop, whoop, whoop.
Scenery. Yeah, and let's get shot up with bullets while we're trying to do this. Double fun on toast, miladio.
At least it's not following you.
Yeah, come and join the fun, why not? Ugh, I'm never going there again.
Fuck all that.
Terrible service.
So I don't know, as a fan of the old series, it's been cute to have it back. I mean, it's not a big...
Well, who really wanted it? I mean, it's like they would keep bringing Futurama back because the fans complain. Who cares? I'm sure it's peaked by now. Let's move on.
I'd be surprised if Futurama came back, but again, you know.
Oh, look, he wasn't ready.
You know. I don't care if things come back. I just ignore them if I don't want to watch them. Haha, got your knees.
No
problem.
Okay, that was clever. They flanked me.
These are the guys who actually went to, like, shoot school.
Bye.
Oh, yeah, you can pop up in different areas.
Yeah. Never know when the Freeman's gonna show up.
You're like the gopher from Caddyshack. Fighting the army of Bill Murray's, which now actually makes more sense than it should have. You know, seeing Gabe, if you swap bodies for 24 hours, what would you do? From Steven the Steve.
Hurt myself in a permanent way.
I'd work out. So, there you go. What would you do? What permanent way?
I'd stick my leg in a wood chipper.
I don't believe if you were to actually feel the pain, which I presume is part of the body swap, that you would have the balls to go through with that.
I'd get very drunk. That's the first thing I'd do. I'd get very drunk. And then look at myself in the mirror and do lots of middle fingers. And go, fuck you. And then drink some more. And then eat an entire cake.
What kind of cake?
The fattiest one I can find. Chocolate cheesecake. Nom, 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 nom. With peanut butter spread all over the top.
You'd die in my body, you dumbass.
No, I wouldn't. Not in one day, I wouldn't.
Yeah, you would. You ate peanuts.
Oh, that's right.
Dumbass.
All right.
There you go.
Forgive me for forgetting your trifling medical
Now
complaint.
I'm just... So now, ultimately, I'd just be taller. In a body that... What are you doing?
I'm blowing up this tank.
I don't... It seems okay.
That's just an optical illusion.
Damn those.
Damn it. Why won't you die? Why won't anything die anymore? Fucking thank you.
I honestly did not expect that to work.
Yeah, the tanks die. Well, the tank isn't actually a object like the helicopter is. It's a collection of brushes, and one of them's just set to be destroyed if you put enough damage into it.
Huh.
I don't know what's going on with the choppers. I think they're definitely...
They're glitched.
Got some glitch going on there.
Something wonky happening. This wonky fucking version of... Puff.
Ow. Yeah, shoot me now, bitch.
I am like the ninja.
That was not a challenge.
Jesus.
Right, you're getting the Gauss.
That was some fucking...
What the hell happened there?
I think he shot you as well.
Ooh, quick draw McGraw.
Ning, ning, ning.
Okay, we got a bit of a reprise of the music now.
That tank really looks like it's stuck there.
This episode really has been an adventure in failure so far, hasn't it?
I don't think this whole thing has been a very good ad for this version of Half-Life.
Well, at least it's funny.
Yuck, 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 yuck. Gabriel, did you know of Yahtzee and Zero Punctuation before you met him? From Codename Zed. Yeah, my brother was a big fan of your
naturally.
Stuff.
Naturally. Who doesn't?
Short answer to my question. My brother's a mutant in that regard, actually. He's really good at getting on things before they get popular, because he was...
Whoa.
Fucking hell!
That's the power of the Gauss. That's what I was expecting the helicopter to do. Hello, lads.
I think he was showing me stuff that you put on YouTube before, it wasn't too long, because I remember him saying that you'd got something at... Escapist, because I'd never heard of Escapist.
Okay.
And then... Because at the time, I didn't have internet where I was living.
Because you're a scrub.
And it was, you know, in Brisbane it could be a real fucking hassle. Back then at least, now it's a lot easier.
Well, so much for the American military.
How does it feel from Truly Else?
Feels good, man.
Do you screen these at all? Like,
I just thought it was that would be fun. Hey, where do you spring from? Why aren't you setting off any mines, you bastard? Ow. That was your ultimate attack, was it?
Uh-huh. Dickhead.
That guy was doing something weird.
Yeah.
There it goes again. This is what we call the Hall of Mirrors effect.
Oh.
It's what the video games put when you don't put something there.
In your skybox. Pistol.
No. It's a matter of principle now.
The fucking AoE on those explosions is ridiculous. That should not have hurt.
I know, man. There's something up there.
Oh, please try and throw that weird fucking fluff nerf grenade into a hole that small. Bayard Rustin is Gabe's role model, but he dodged the draft for World War II. Why does Gabe support the Nazis?
Yeah,
Hate
Gabe.
Is good for you.
Why do you support
because
the Nazis?
The Nazis would have exterminated a functional retard like Hate is good for you.
Okay.
Actually managed.
Yeah. There was a sniper there. Not anymore.
Help me. Somebody, please help me. I'm dying.
Help him in the head, Yahtzee. Please. Help me. Look at the agony on his face.
Yeah, I think he was already dead at that point. Mouth was just going through the motions. No, they're mine.
Is there any way to, like, see them or find them?
Well, you could toss some explosives ahead of you, but if you just stick to the walls, you'll probably be alright. No!
Perfect.
Good timing there.
You guys live in Australia. Fuck!
We certainly do.
That explains the heat.
Yeah.
That just looks awful. Just looks awful.
They put Roman candles in with the mines on it. Alright.
Did that... Must have. Oh, whoa!
What? Ah, you bastards. Man, you're really putting all your effort into this one, aren't you? Mines and snipers. Yeah, I think
just presume he's dead.
I think that did it.
Oh, there's electricity. Whoa! The power of the gods.
Shouldn't have eaten that funny looking cactus while we were in the desert section.
Is the
electricity gone. That's how electricity works, kids.
Just shoot it.
Yeah, explode it. And then, what the hell?
So I was wondering if you have seen the ABC show.
I think there's some kind of UFO over there.
Huh. Good game. And if so, what are your thoughts on it? From Noick Noick.
The skybox is fucked.
Noick Noick.
Yes, I'm familiar with Good Game. I used to know the presenters. It's one of the few network television video game shows in Australia.
I met the presenters once or twice. I haven't watched it.
The perception I get is that network television doesn't usually like doing video game shows. At least that was the impression we got when we were trying to make Game Damage.
It seems like an awful lot of effort for no real purpose these days. I mean, why are they going to go out of their way to try and compete with Twitch and YouTube? And
well, you might as well argue why have any network television at all by that token.
Well, no, because, you know, certain elements of network television, like complex scripted dramas, require the kind of, you know, upfront money and organization and structure that, you know, YouTube doesn't have, whereas sitting around yammering on about video games is a relatively low...
Well, it's a magazine show, isn't it?
Yeah.
YouTube's
full of that.
Like, networks are plenty of... full of magazine shows.
Well, yeah, it's because it counts as, like, local content, which I believe is probably a chunk of why Good Game still exists.
Not all magazine shows are local content.
Australian ones are. The ones produced by local networks, which is what we're talking about.
Now, if anything explodes...
Is that steaming?
Yeah. Half-Life's big on just one-time weird effects. That you think if they were going to do once, they would do with more things. But not. Now, if anything explodes in this room, you'll note the enormous missiles overhead. Here we see more military thinking in action. If anything explodes here, basically the entire base gets nuked. So we'd better not explode things.
Not how nukes work.
Don't mumble. And the objective though it's not obvious, is to get in there.
Okie dokie, can that be exploded? That looks
nope,
safe.
Nope, not even that.
Really?
I might just demonstrate, actually.
No. Aww.
Fade to white, what a cop-out. Oh, and the gun's still working. Yeah, that was just Freeman going blind. Limbo.
Yahtzee mentioned the...
Oh, you dumb cluck.
Marvellous.
That was all you.
Yahtzee mentioned the goons a few times sporadically. Were you a big fan? And has their works influenced yours in any way? From Random 44.
I wouldn't say I was a big fan. I mean, I've listened to a bit of the Goon Show.
Ooh.
That's what you're supposed to do. But the Goon Show was so influential in British comedy, you could argue that if you're influenced by pretty much anything that came after it, you were influenced by it. Monty Python in particular.
Who was it? Was Milligan on the Goon Show?
Yeah, it was Spike Milligan, yeah. Peter Sellers.
That's right, yeah.
And Harry H. Corbett.
Corbett I'm not familiar with. Although, I might have... I don't know. It's probably one of those ones that I've seen, but just don't know the name of. British comedians can be kind of like classical
music
in that way.
Not Corbett, Seacombe. That's who I was thinking of. Harry Seacombe. Who was...
Is that a gun you can pick up?
Yes. I'm saving it. I'm, like, taking some savory moments. Yes. It's the Hornet gun. Let's see how useful it is.
Wasn't this the thing that...
Aha! Kill the soldiers with the homing flies! Oh, I shot him once.
Kill him.
See? This could have been avoided. You could have stopped that. Yeah, see, the hook hand is homing, and the weapon ammo regenerates, but you only get 8 bullets of, like, high-speed fire.
I don't think those are homing so great.
No, it's basically useless. Oh, piss.
Amazing.
Let's try this again.
Yahtzee, if you move to America and get a new house, will you finally be able to fulfill your wish of getting a dog from Mortimer 42?
Ooh, I hope so.
What are you gonna, get a sausage dog called Cumberland?
No.
What?
I'll just get a dog.
So, some kind of, like, mongrel...
Well, I won't know, will I? I'll go to the rescue shelter and see what they've got.
That's gonna hurt you.
Yeah.
Behold, I Mantok, the Mind Taker!
Yeah, you better run.
Where are you going? Oh, fuck, this section is making me upset. This is horrible to watch. Alright, so you're gonna get a dog, you're gonna go down to the pound, it's gonna find whatever jumps and slobbers on you first. Yep.
Oh, pish.
Do you think the retro-style gaming scene will ever evolve to include the types of games younger generations are nostalgic for, such as turn-of-the-millennium shooters like Half-Life?
Of course, I'd only get a dog if I was living in a house, but I don't really like living in houses. I'm more of an apartment-stroke-condo man. I mean, it's not fair on the dog if you haven't got a nice big garden and space to run for him to run around in.
Not really.
Hey! Look at you!
Blast him in the face. He can't be allowed to live. He's too strong.
Did he just make a noise?
Yes.
He made a noise with his mouth. Kill it! they die in such appropriate poses.
There can be only one.
Ooh, I'm just beat.
Generally, so, yes. I don't think so, because I think Half-Life, it's that thing of what you're aiming at. Like, I think Half-Life was aiming at realism.
I think the trouble with early, like, 3D games, turn of the millennium 3D, is that it is very ugly.
Yeah.
I mean, 2D games, especially in the 16-bit era, looked alright.
They were stylized.
Yeah, it was stylized. You could live with it. But early 3D games almost universally look like absolute shit.
Yeah, well, that's.
I don't think people have the same nostalgia for it that they have for 2D retro.
No.
I've seen screenshots of people trying to recreate a sort of PS1 aesthetic, but, you know, why would you want to?
That's like one of the worst. Those textures were awful.
Yeah, and the 3D kept wobbling around all over the place. Ah, what are you doing here? Supposed to be dead.
Oh,
from the airstrike.
Doki.
You asshole.
I mean, I don't think there's anything about this version that we're playing, or the original source, that's that much better than, you know, the sort of nicer looking one on the more recent engine.
Bleh.
Whereas I think like 2D and sprite based, again, you get different gameplay styles.
Well, the bad 3D sort of like affects the efficiency of the game as well, because things can be ugly and hard to make out. So it's, you know, less efficient to play. Ow!
Fuck-a-do.
Fucking hell. What is that, a fucking hit-scan explosive?
Maybe...
Got
it.
Yeah, that threw me straight off the platform there.
Yeah, it does have there. Some, it does have some kick.
Oh, shit! Ow.
Okay. Die now. Die.
Yes. Thank you for the advice, Gabriel.
I wasn't advising you, I was advising them.
Oh.
I don't want you to die. I'm going to have to do this bit again.
You know, well, you do want me to die in my general terms, though, don't you?
No, as long as you're alive, you're suffering.
More snipers. I presume.
The fuck
I do. Yeah, they're just bombing the place now.
See, yeah, that's the...
They're getting the really trigger-happy, stupid pilots in on the fun. Let's bomb several areas we currently occupy and control.
As long as Freeman's there, they don't control it. I think they've come to accept that now.
They will never control anything.
You can't control the free man.
Their wives belong to me now. Their children will...
Call me father. Yeah,
they will call me father.
You're gonna teach your son how to shave, motherfucker.
Yeah, badly.
Mm.
You'd probably done a better job.
It'll look
guess
like a
we'll never know.
Dick.
Come over here, lassie. Little Timmy's trapped down the storage well.
Yeah, I don't think I don't think these kinds of games are retro styled so much as they're an attempt at something they couldn't really accomplish.
Christmas morning.
It's delicious.
We don't get an official get our weapons back, but we do get this.
Yahtzee endgame. How would you describe your perfect woman? Appearance, personality, etc.
Well, I'm going to sit out of this one because I have a significant other. So why don't you take the lead?
Yeah, this question is if you have a girlfriend, this is asking for trouble.
Well, yes.
Annoyingly,
if your guns aren't...
out, you know, yeah.
Filled up, then it won't count.
Just bullshit. Personality of Agent Scully from seasons 1 and 2 looks like Ruth Negga.
You like a skeptic, do you?
Well, like, season 1 and 2 Scully was great. Like, just take no shit, fucking, like, tackle a serial killer, like, you know. That's a quality woman. She has her shit together, she's not insane, she can probably fill out a tax form by herself without crying.
Would it
like,
not be quicker to say Clarice Starling?
No, I think Clarice was a little uptight.
And she
Scully had a better sense of humor.
And depending on what version, what ending of Hannibal you've seen.
Yeah. I go with the books.
Well, where they become chums.
Yes. So
they become bum chums.
that's the homos, Yahtzee. Yeah, that was a...
Men and women can still bum.
That was a fascinating... Yeah,
they
but
can
that's
just
not
bum
chums.
In a one, bum
like,
in a one-way sort of direction.
Bum chums of homos. That's...
Bye, guys. I don't care.
Yeah, not dealing with this. Yeah, so... No, I'm like, I... Even Clarice in the books didn't have that great a sense of humor. I like Scully. And Ruth Negga, because she is just absurdly attractive and was perfectly cast as the kind of woman without mutant abilities that can just get you to do things with her eyes.
Okay.
Pew!
Oh, Osprey.
Can you destroy that? Can you rocket it?
The...
Can you shoot the dudes as they're climbing down? Never mind.
Bye, guys, again.
Alright, is that a thing? No, he's gonna run past it.
Shit.
Fucking Jesus, oh!
Yeah, I wasn't ready for that.
Alright.
Yeah, ideally, the soldiers fight the alien grunts.
Right.
I gotta see if I can wait for the soldiers to arrive before I summon the grunts.
Is it invincible?
The Osprey?
Yeah.
I think it is. I don't think I've ever destroyed it.
Maybe try. Let's try now. Let's see. Can we do it? Get the rockets out. Come on, you just got armed up. Blast it.
No, I don't wanna. Right. Everyone join the party. Come on, guys. Yeah. Ain't no party like a US military party.
I'm conscientiously objecting.
US military short bus party. This is essentially a speeded up version of someone playing XCOM for the first time.
This is what happens when...
Except with better visibility.
Well, this military unit was created after executing the retarded got banned. They're just like, you know what, let's just... We'll put them in a very special forces and...
That's the trouble with the double shot. It's a bit slower to... Bleh!
My gun shot bees. Why did they give me the bee gun?
Where did that alien soldier come from?
Teleport, maybe?
Follow me, man.
Favorite Kinks songs from Crickland.
Well, you can't go wrong with Lola. But I got a soft spot for the Village Green Preservation Society as well.
How did they do that?
Yes. Huh. The one that goes, we are the Village Green Preservation Society. God save Tudor houses and stuff and things. I forget the rest. Hey!
England for the English. Surely that got his brain.
Well, that's probably why he survived.
Yeah.
There's so little there. That's the annoying thing is the soldiers will spawn indefinitely from the offspray. Happily, we have this scenario.
Dun 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 dun.
Can't aim upwards, though. It's to blow up this door here. I'll just shoot it a few more times in case there's...
Just to clear the space out.
Yeah, in case there's fun time havers beyond the door. Right, that'll do.
Okay, what is your opinion on Street Fighter V's almost early access style launch with its lack of content and online functions?
Ow!
Largely a shit fight.
It's a shit fight. This is a shit
fight. Well, you only say that because I repeatedly fight people with shit.
Ow.
Yeah, it's been kind of frustrating and weird. Like, it's one of those situations where, you know, if I invite you over to dinner and I say I'm going to make you a really fancy dinner, and then it's just sausages on bread.
When the hell have you ever invited people over to dinner?
Well, it's a hypothetical, Yahtzee.
Don't speak from ignorance.
I have invited people over to dinner.
Use an analogy related to things you actually do in life.
Well, I have done this.
Have you ever disappointed a woman in bed?
Probably, but I'm willing to bet I was too fuck drunk to care.
We were supposed to use the turret for this, but turrets are shit.
Yeah, they really are.
But then so am I. So perhaps we should get along.
Boom. Maybe turret it up now. I mean, can you hide? Like,
fuck.
No, can you crouch behind the turret? Does that, like, keep you safe?
I'm gonna assume this is working.
And I'm assumed wrong!
Yeah, assumed wrong, apparently. I can't even see the buggers.
This is not well implemented. Now you're doing alright. The beta... Because the thing is, it was released... early for a variety of reasons.
Fuck.
Jesus.
Sake.
Shit. Okay, get rockets and shit. Grenades. Like, maybe some boom boom will deal with these. Cuddle the wall on the left behind the lump of honeycomb? And you gotta aim a little higher, because I think
I can't move from the turret.
You're clipping the lip of the hill a bit. Like, I think. Oh, no, there you go. Yeah, now you're getting it. I was expecting. More server issues with the actual release. Well, it was released because people need practice, you know, the competitive element need practice before, like, the Capcom Pro Tour starts. And to basically, you know, get it all sorted. And to be perfectly honest...
Capcom Pro Tour? What is it? Fucking golf now?
Yeah, it is. But with, like, Street Fighter. Which is fine. And again, as someone who's both keenly interested in the plot elements and also the competitive side of it, I was okay with
that.
Jumping up and down on a weird alien boil. And I was prepared for that. And I was even prepared for some basic online hiccups just because of the sheer volume of people that were going to get fucking dogpiled on. You know,
hi, lads. Have some friends.
Even with the beta, I was expecting a little bit of a hassle. It's the hassles that exist still are weird. Because, like, the online works fine. It's just things like matchmaking in Battle Lounge and stuff keep crashing. But, like, ranked matches and casual matches, when you get them, are great. They're fucking great. Like, they're smooth as fucking silk. It's amazing. Like, for, you know, somebody who struggled to play Street Fighter 4 online, you know, even, you know, with good internet, as, you know, largely as good as Australia gets, it was still unreliably laggy crap. Now I can actually play functional online.
Okay. Who cares?
Then there's just lots of weird things, like the arcade mode is there, but there's just no matches in it for some weird reason, and that's a decision that I think is fucking stupid. Okay. Oh, you can pick those ones up.
And I seem to remember there being some visual differentiation between the ones you can pick up and the ones you can't, but not in this version.
Yeah, let me go. Yeah. So, yeah, it's been a shit fight. Mine will crash in 14 minutes. I don't know why.
Hope you like set pieces, kids. Yep, there's soldiers down there. Perhaps they'd like a friend or 15.
Ah, Beatles!
Tee-hee.
That was fun. I don't think it's been as ultimate as a shit fight as... I mean, there's been some just absolute hate about it, but I don't think it deserves that. I think in... There are some circumstances where we... Like, I knew I was getting an unfinished thing. I think the way they presented it, the way they've sold it as being sort of finished was stupid.
What the fuck?
Did you lower the car on yourself?
I don't know.
I think you lowered the car on yourself. You know, if they just said, we're gonna release this, it's not quite finished, but look, you wanna play the, you know, you want, like, offline multiplayer and some other shit, so...
Alright.
They didn't do that, and I think that's where a lot of the mistake was.
Is there any chance you two could play a couple rounds of Two Truths and a Lie? From Gabriel M. Facts, your friend.
I wonder who that is.
How does one play Two Truths and a Lie? Is it how it sounds?
I figure you tell two things that are true about you and one lie, and people have to guess, like, well, what's bullshit.
I can't think of anything...
Maybe come back to this one next week.
I can't think of anything true about me I haven't already said on these videos.
Yeah. We're not very... You know, we're fairly open people.
Alright. Let me try. Facts number one. I have three close relatives in the police force, or retired from the police force. Fact number two, I have broken one wrist. Fact number three,
Yeah, you did. You lowered a car on yourself.
I can trace my family tree to Hitler. Which one of those is a lie? Do you think?
The police force.
Easily.
Yeah.
No.
Whoop.
That was true. My mother is a retired policewoman.
Huh.
And two of my paternal uncles are as well.
So there was no chance of you being a plod?
Not my speed, really.
I don't know, I can see you saying, what's all this then?
What's all this then?
I think you gotta, like, activate it and then run onto it.
Yeah, you gotta stand on it like a dumb twat.
Run, Yahtzee. Yay.
Hey. There's an infestation of jerks. Right then. Now your turn. Tell me two true things and a lie.
My family had a formative role in the Australian Labor Party. There was a period in my life where I was monstrously racist. There was a period in my life where I was making something up for this.
I don't think you're trying hard enough, Gabriel.
No.
When were you racist, then?
I wasn't.
Besides all the time.
No, the true one was, like, my family's got a... Like, the Prime Minister visited my great-uncle or something, who was like, because Barkholden was where my family's, like, one of the chunks of my family's from, and that's where the Labour Party's from.
Oh.
So there's a big portion of,
So yeah. what was the second true thing, then?
Oh, was it two truths?
Yeah.
Okay, two truths, well, the second truth was I was making shit up for this.
Okay. That was a very stupid round of two truths and a lie. Yeah. Thanks for your contribution. What are you shooting at, strange man? Oh, that guy. Well, perhaps I could help you out.
You got him in the bum.
Tee-hee. That was fun, wasn't it? Perhaps you'd like some, too.
Oh, God.
Spaz
scroll
out.
Scroll the questions down, and then I'm going to have another conversation with you about you should filter these stupid things.
No.
Daciously, your question's stupid.
Yeah, I thought
you can
that.
Read that.
No, you read it. I think that's a fun question.
Has
give
anyone
it, give
really
it
been
deserves.
Far even has decided to use even go want to do more like? More to the point, have either of you?
What's so stupid about that question?
Because it's that stupid fucking copy-paste gibberish double dutch question.
Okay.
It's old. It's not been funny for ages.
I haven't heard of it.
It's weird because you're on the internet more than I am. Like,
yeah,
you dick
well,
around
obviously
on the
I don't read stupid bullshit.
No,
like
and
you.
That's why you wind up putting them on our fucking question list like a dingbat.
Oh, well, I'm sorry. Maybe perhaps, obviously, you would prefer to take that task week to week.
You once mentioned you were learning how to cook. Have you kept up with that? And if so, have you made anything really good lately? From Dark Silverhawk.
Somewhat.
How are you going?
Last thing I made was a chicken noodle soup.
Oh, what noodles?
I just used sort of spaghetti that had been broken into thirds.
Yeah.
And,
what was the process?
Well, I fried up some vegetables, then added chicken and stock, and then let it simmer for ages. Wasn't that great, though. It was a lot better after I'd let it sit in the fridge for a while, and then, reboiled it up, reduced it a bit, added some more stock powder and some garlic pepper. Then it was much nicer.
I make a similar thing, but it's sort of got a little bit of a, I think Filipino. My lady friend at the time was Filipino and told me how to cook it.
Okay.
And it's kind of like a chicken soup, except you use stock, there's some fish sauce in there, a bit of ginger, some chili. And then you boil it all up, and then you put in, glutinous rice, like about a cup of glutinous rice, and it turns into this really nice kind of, it thickens it quite well, so you end up with sort of a, not as thick as porridge, but sort of porridgey, and that's, I make a big bowl of that every now and again, and that's sort of, that's meals for a while. Yahtzee, do you ever think there will come a day when you stop reviewing the Game of the Year franchises, such as COD, Sassy Cretins, okay? Because you feel like you said all there was to say on them, or do you think the chance to wax poetic on how samey they are?
Well,
sanity meter.
They can always surprise you, you know. I mean,
have an example of one that maybe
well,
came out?
Well, Spec Ops was part of a series. There was Spec Ops was an established series when Spec Ops: The Line came out. Completely unrelated to it, of course. But all the like Call of Duties and the Modern Warfare stories and stuff seems to be unrelated to each other these days. And they really seem to be trying, especially with the Black Ops ones. They came up with this really weird story for the last one, which was about, you know, altered perceptions and cyber augmentation. And this weird connecting visual themes, like this whole notion of a frozen forest, which was a hypnotic state that... it's kind of weird. I didn't really get what the plot actually was.
You know, you're selling me on this. I'm interested now.
They made for some weird twist at the end where it turned out you were one of the villains all along or something, or maybe I didn't get that at all. But it was, it just left me with more questions. I had no idea what it was going on about. Okay, that was supposed to despawn game, because the explosive has exploded now. Hi, I'm alive.
You cannot kill me, I am the free man. Floaty guns do not scare free man.
Free man, find more friends.
Grenade. You fool.
I want to see how this works out. Hey,
shoot
the aliens, you stupid assholes.
Yahtzee and Gabe, how would you describe your perfect Sundays from Troggy42?
One for the head crabs. Perfect Sunday.
Shooting the Irish.
The best Sundays are the Sundays after you got completely drunk the previous night. I went out last night, had some drinks in a bar,
Mother of God.
Incidentally, there's a new bar in where the Manor Bar was.
Mm.
I didn't go in, though. It looked like it was full of hipsters.
It really is. It's an art bar. It's amazing.
Okay.
It's A-grade quality hipster.
Fucking ladders. Right, here's more precarious standing on
things. Did
you
go out with people, or did you go out by yourself?
I usually like to walk around the valley, get something to eat. And I go to, like, my favourite bar where I know the staff. And then now it's Pillar Bar.
Pillock.
But yes, I still know the people there, and we hang out and chat. And that's how I like to, round off the week. And when I'm good and hungover the following morning, I've got a good excuse to go out to one of the nearby cafes and have a big stodgy breakfast. Oh, for fuck's sake. I didn't even have line of sight from their guns there.
Not fair, they're shooting.
Well, they are. And we're all the way back here now. And then...
Fire!
After a stodgy breakfast, maybe I'd like to take a walk before noon.
What do you do on a walk?
I just walk around. And walk.
Well, yeah, but do you have direction do you go? Do you just throw a dice and then...
Usually go into either the city, or walk up to the valley, walk through one of the parks. And here's this again. Oh yeah, headcrabs are schooling now.
Good job, little guys.
What's your perfect Sunday, Gabriel?
Usually on Sundays I do a bit of room cleaning and general tidying. I've done a little bit of that already today, but I kind of want to get... I'm doing a sort of a major reorganize so I can have everything sort of neat for school starting next week. And then I sit down and I loaf about and play some games.
Okay then.
I found managed to get the old point and click Blade Runner working, which has been a lot of fun.
That was a weird one. It was sort of the plot of the film, but not really.
Mm. Yeah, it was kind of...
It was just, you were a different Blade Runner.
Jesus.
But you were sort of going through the same motions that Deckard was doing.
These guys are... Grenade.
I haven't got my grenades ready.
Poo-poos. I've taken a lot of shotgun damage.
Yeah, that was fucked. I knew this health was here. That's why I went here with such confidence.
You strode in.
Yep.
What do you guys think of the Australian flag? Does it need to change from Achtung, etc.?
This is a weird little set piece. When we walk into this area, this area that was probably nice before the bombing started, this one security guard standing next to this destroyed desk pulls his gun out and goes, "Stand back!" And then he puts it away and says, "Hello."
Alright.
So maybe he assumes we're a soldier. Maybe he was this was his idea of barricading himself in. Except not really.
Just powerbombed a head crab through that table.
Now we need this milk toast.
So you can't murder him?
No.
Aww.
If we murdered him, we'd get the screen. Yes. This screen.
Ah, Jesus.
What a wanky corporate way of putting, "Don't kill the vital guy."
Yeah, it really is.
Some scoliosis there, Barney.
I don't really... I think the flag... I mean, I have the Simpsons boot flag sort of flapping around on my front door, so that's fun.
I've never really thought about it that much, if I'm honest.
Yeah, I mean, I don't care, really.
It's the Southern Cross and the Union Jack. Those are two fine things.
I just don't care. I did see one... This was ages ago now, I think I was in year 10, a comedian in one of the Melbourne International Comedy Festivals say that it should just be, the Union Jack should be replaced with a picture of a bum with a fist coming out of it. And that made me giggle back then, and it's made me giggle ever since. Something about the fist coming, I don't know, it's just so...
Lame?
It's...
Stupid?
Yeah, but in kind of just an absurd way that tickles me.
All right, you take care of that. I'll watch the rear.
Fist coming out of it.
Well, aren't you going to fight him?
I Apparently not.
Man, you prioritize when you're going to blindly attack the enemy for no reason, don't you?
Let's see. You once mentioned an extra punctuation that you dabbled with the Half-Life level editor. Did you manage to make a complete level with it?
Are you coming? Board? Hello? I suppose this is the exciting chase.
He's trying to get one of the cars started.
You're supposed to chase us all the way out of this tunnel. Don't make me come back there. Is he making out with his girlfriend? Pah, kids these days.
And your hormones.
Where the fuck did he go? There you are. Right. Now. Well, never mind then. Okay, now he's chasing. And it's sad that I had to do that, isn't it, Mr. Gargantua?
Go back and...
Isn't it so much nicer when we all do our jobs? Right.
I'm in. Cooper, do you copy? Forget about Freeman.
No, he doesn't copy. Yeah, he's saying forget about Freeman. That's not doesn't mean the soldiers aren't going to keep shooting you.
Get the hell out of there. Repeat, we are...
So here's fun. We've got a tactical map here. We've got a tactical map that tells the military what to bomb. So we're going to bomb that Gargantua first off. And it's not going to work. Oh well.
You can't bomb him again?
What's going on? Hey!
Fucking glorious.
That was a dodgy thing. Will you be joining us this time? Oh god, yes. Oh, he ain't.
He probably got
about.
Stuck on that car.
Oh, he's coming now.
He just didn't activate his little car fucking throw animation.
Yeah, I did some messing about with the valve hammer editor. What of it?
Well, he asked if you've completed a level with it.
No.
Question answered.
I'm
return to life.
Yeah, I copy. Forget about Freeman, we're abandoning the base. Blow up the...
Gabe, is it possible to live in happily in Australia if you're terrified of spiders? Yeah.
Yeah, I mean... I was worried about that before I moved over here. But turns out there's not actually that many. At least not in the inner city.
No. Suburban Sydney, you probably got to worry about. You know, just don't...
Just lift the toilet seat before you sit on it. It's not hard.
Yeah, and you know, you learn the areas you're not to go, and things you're not to do.
You know what? I like this guy. He's got a casual approach to life that I think we can all get behind. Doesn't mean I'm not going to blow him up in the most disappointing possible way.
No, that is not a.
Well, the idea is we've got to blow up this bit of wall here. And,
the door.
And the door. But there's quite a few other things we can blow up while we're here.
Ooh, like what? Like that?
Yeah. And we can blow up... all of this shit. So we've got a way over there.
Ah.
I think we can blow up that tower as well, just for giggles.
Excellent. Destroy it all!
Or not.
Nope.
Oh well.
Christmas is cancelled. Nothing is fun ever again.
So, as soon as you get here, the military gets bored and just starts bombing everything. Then fuck it, right? I mean, we're trained to carpet bomb things for a reason.
It's not carpet bombing if it's not to the edges.
So now we get to be back below. Hooray. Gotta love being underground all the time, because apparently I'm a mole.
You can be happy underground.
I've heard that. In fact, I think I will soon be going underground.
Mm.
When the brass band's playing, feet start to pound, don't you know?
Fucking Jesus.
Yeah. Oh, that's lucky. I can stand on this and not get destroyed by any further ceiling collapse.
Right, because ceiling can't collapse onto other ceiling. That's a scientific
fact. Exactly, yeah, it's like lightning. Man, they really gave a shit about me.
Forget about Freeman. Now destroy everything in a desperate attempt to stop him.
Huh. Man wins versus machine.
Versus, like, Gatling turret.
Well, he had a head start.
I suppose. And he is Barney the Invulnerable.
You come with me. Yes, running like hell is one option, Barney. Another possibility is you could die for me.
Die for me, Barney. Barney, die for me. They shot your grenade, Yahtzee.
Bastards.
The bees!
Yeah. Oh, oh, and the guys over there as well. That was,
Maybe you should activate them and then activate the turret.
There's a thought.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm using my noodle.
You come with me.
Yahtzee, will you move back to Australia if you break up with your girlfriend from Theog?
Oh, no. Because, as I said before, I'm going there for my job and some other reasons. Not just because of
the escapist are implanting a small explosive in the base of Yahtzee's neck.
You useless fucking turret.
Wait. Nope. All right. I don't think the problem is the monsters aren't coming. So they're sort of over there and the turret's here and just a bit of an issue, really.
This is quite maddening. I'm just going to turn it off.
Fuck it.
Try and range him. Because you're a rangy motherfucker. Why
were you hitting him? Like,
I did then.
There you go.
There we go.
Ouch.
Right.
If you were an animal, which would you be from Big Griffin?
I would be a big griffin. Gabriel?
Okay. A manticore.
Okay. Why?
I don't know, you said you'd be a griffin, so I was like, oh, I'd be a mythical beast, too.
Fucking poser.
Yeah. I shouldn't.
Just you.
That's it. I'm insulting your honest griffin kin status.
You chase
stuff.
I'm making fun of you for chasing trends. What are you, Ubisoft?
The burn.
Feel the burn. Although apparently he lost, Nevada. Well, there was another narrow one. At this point, narrow ones are as good as victories for old Byrne. Sanders, I mean.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I think at the moment it's the Democrats doing Nevada and the Republicans doing North Carolina.
Oh, okay.
I don't think it's Hillary and Trump wins.
Fascinating.
Well, that's what I just heard today.
What the? I don't remember those. Disco balls of doom.
Yeah, they make snarks come out.
Yeah.
Ah, I tried to hunt the snark. It did not go well. Ah, fuck it. Let's end the episode here. Well, we got through surface tension.
Huzzah! Yahtzee didn't kill the helicopter, never forget.
Now we're nearly on our way to the last section of the game.
That wasn't very fun, if memory serves.
Well,
weird bouncy boss level.
But hey, it'll be a change of scene from these underground tunnels and car parks.
Space.
How many car parks does one fucking underground facility the size of Disney World need?
And we've not really seen that many cars.
Well, we saw like three that the Gargantua was throwing about.
Yeah, but how did everyone else? Do they carpool? Must carpool.
Well, they use the fucking tram, dude. At the start.
Yeah, but does the tram pick them up from their house?
Probably.
Huh.
Well, they live on site.
Ah,
there's
so there
dormitories.
Is an on-site living thing.
Yeah, they say in the opening spiel
remember it word for word.
Your train was en route from dormitories. No plot holes, no worries.
I wonder why those cars are there then. I wonder who does drive, who commutes.
Shut up. It is all makes sense.
Ah, okay.
Right.
One of the Barneys.
Right. Now let's tell a joke to finish off with.
Okay.
Give me a parameter.
Psychologist.
Okay. Bloke walks into a psychologist's office wearing a cling film nappy and nothing else.
Seen this guy in the valley.
And he says to the psychologist, "Doctor, be honest with me. Do you think I'm crazy?" And the psychologist says, "Dude, anyone can see your fucking nuts."
Nah.
Because you see he's wearing a cling film nappy.
Yeah.
Thus exposing his testicles.
Nuts.
Good. I'm glad you came with me on that. See you next time.
Bye.